Hi, I'm Damon Smith, Extension Field Crops Pathologist at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. I'd like to give a little update on some work we've been doing in a coordinated effort with the Corn Disease Working Group, which is a national working group of corn pathologists, which have conducted a set of fungicide trials across the entire corn belt. Today we're actually standing out in a second iteration of that work, but I'd like to talk about what we learned out of the very first iteration of our coordinated fungicide trials. And in that work, what we did was we compared demethylation inhibitor fungicides plus QOI fungicides with single mode of action fungicides. So in other words, we were looking at single and double mode of action products. And then we layered fungicide application timing within each of those modes of action. And what we actually learned is that if we just look at yield advantage over the non-treated control, early V6 application timings were good for about a 3-bushel advantage over the non-treated control versus the tassel timing, which actually had about a 7.2-bushel advantage over the non-treated control. So clearly, across the corn belt, if we just again look at yield and we don't consider disease levels, we can see that the tassel application timing by far out-yielding that early V6 timing. We also looked at two-pass applications where we came in at the V6 timing and then followed up at the tassel timing. That allowed a gain of about 1 bushel over the single application at VT. If you look at the economics of that situation, obviously the two-pass program is going to be very hard to get a positive return on investment. So really we think the best place to actually apply fungicide if you're just after an advantage in yield and you want to reduce some of the disease pressure would be again at that tassel to R1 fungicide application timing, and looking at two modes of action in your products, as those did give us a little bit of advantage over a single mode of action type product. We do have ongoing coordinated work, which is being done through the Corn Disease Working Group, where we're actually comparing now two-way modes of action with the newer three-way modes of action, and also looking at tassel versus R3 application timings. This is ongoing work, and some of the preliminary results there are pretty consistent with what we learned in the first iteration of this work, where the tassel timing giving us a strong advantage and not really any advantage with waiting until that R3. But again, ongoing work, and we're going to be adding to this data set. If you'd like to learn more about field crops pathology, feel free to visit badgercropdoc.com or contact your local extension agent.